Bicycles arrived today.
Sorry, sir?
The new push bikes. I'll be in at parade to have a word about them.
Oh, right, sir.
Pump, 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 pump.
I was about to see you in this morning.
Yeah, well, I spent all day yesterday at the hospital. There's nothing I can do there, though.
Well, how is he now?
The rest of him's falling apart, but his heart's as strong as an ox.
Morning, Acklin.
Good morning, sir. I mean, they're even talking about maybe letting him home in a couple of days.
Good morning, Josh.
Yeah?
Morning, Jill.
Yeah, morning.
Yeah, well, that's what I said.
Look, we're one down in the cab room today. Do you want to have a day inside? Be near the phone?
Yeah, if that's all right.
Yeah, all right.
Thanks, sir.
Morning, man.
Morning, Bob.
Morning, Alec.
Hello, Robert.
You're in early this morning. Playing the CAD room, is it?
Yep. 8 hours of uninterrupted sitting down.
Yeah, what would you do without it, eh?
Go sick a lot.
Anyway, so be there.
Morning, Alec.
Morning, sir. Morning, Sarge.
Hey, Marvin. Hey. Today's the day. Hey?
Operation Mushroom.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Sarge, why mushroom?
Because they keep him in the dark and feed him on horse shit.
Morning, Gunners.
You better get chumped out.
I'm fed up of flats anyway. I want to go back to Club 1830.
Morning, lady.
You're in a section house.
Yeah, but it's all laid on for you there, isn't it, eh?
Oh, miss the blue-eyed probationers, do you, Nick?
Yeah, I do. Yeah.
Morning, team.
Morning.
Sarge. Morning, Sarge.
We're thin on the ground, aren't we? Right, first things first.
Sorry, I'm late, Skipper.
Defective traffic lights, junction of Commercial Road and Tamling Street. Any volunteers for point duty? Come on, it has stopped raining. Well, temporarily.
Sorry, I'm late, sir.
Oh, no problem, Edwards. I've just penciled you in for today's plum job.
Traffic lights are out to Tamling Street again.
Yeah.
Traffic's snarling up already.
You'll soon have it sorted.
What? Oh, give us a break, Sarge.
Yeah, I will, about 9:30. All right, Viv, number 3 foot patrol and a school crossing at Mantree Juniors. And ignore the lorry drivers, I don't want any accidents.
Oh, yes.
Sure, Panda 2, please. Smith, yes, van to the garage and then to the front desk. And Patel, number 1 foot patrol.
Aye,
June, CAD room as discussed. And Sergeant Peters has got some homemade cake, so you'll be well looked after, though. All right, and the rest of you, watch out. Because I'm going to be out on the streets today, and if I don't see anyone, questions will be asked. Okay.
Morning, everyone.
Morning, sir.
How do you finish, Sergeant?
More or less, sir. Yeah, just a few general notices.
May I?
Yes, of course, sir. Carry on.
Thank you. Just to say that our new bicycles have been delivered today, and that I should be looking for a positive attitude towards both the machines and those who ride them. Now, you may say, of course, that the bicycle is no answer to armed robbery, to riots, to mugging, to drug abuse, but nothing better exemplifies the human, friendly face of policing than the bobby on his bike.
But aren't they meant for home mates, really, sir?
Primarily, yes. However, I don't see the fact that we're deficient in that quarter at the moment as any reason for not deploying our new resources. That being so, I would like 2 volunteers to mount up today to attend a community function on the Porterfield Estate.
Porterfield Estate? Last time I was there, sir, I was sat inside an armoured carrier.
Exactly, sure. But times change. I have to. Well, perhaps it would be appropriate if you were one of the heralds of the new era.
Me, sir?
Yeah. You're an authorised cyclist, aren't you?
Yeah, but, I mean, I'm on Panda 2 today.
It's only for an hour at the end of the relief. And... Edwards, I think.
What a surprise, eh?
You'll be glad of a change after point duty.
Yes, sir.
Right, I'll brief you both later. Thank you, Sergeant.
Thank you, sir.
Now, listen, when I was at Dulwich, we had this traffic sergeant, right? He's a right evil soul.
Yeah.
So one day, we got hold of his boots, we got one of the lads to go down the stables, and... Ah, morning, Bob.
Right, Tom?
Yeah, fine, thanks. You?
Yeah, fine. June Ackman's going to cover in here today, OK?
Many thanks, Robert.
And I'm out on patrol, so you're going to have to pay for your own bleeding breakfast this morning.
You mean I can pay for it? So, we'll keep everything crossed, eh?
Look, nothing can go wrong. It's planning and teamwork, the very thing we in the Met are noted for.
Yeah, like I said, we'll keep everything crossed. Oh, morning, June. How's your dad?
Oh, not too bad.
Good.
Good. Yeah. Bitch, Dad.
Oh, no thanks, Alec. But early in the morning for me.
I think the best thing you can do, Mr. Grimwade, is to write to the Duchess of Brunsbeck. You see, she takes a particular interest in this sort of thing, you know. So if you could just do your letter out again, address it to the Duchess of Brunsbeck, I'm sure she'd be well pleased. OK, then, sir. Do you think you can manage that?
Yeah.
Right, Tom. Oh, mind how you go, sir. Bye-bye, Mr. Grimwade.
Who's that man, Smith?
Oh, he's just a nutter, sir.
A nutter?
Well, he's one of our regulars, sir. Mr. Grimwade. Tell him to write to the Duchess of Bransby and he goes away well pleased.
And who exactly is the Duchess of Bransby?
Don't know, sir. I made up a few months ago.
Oh, I see. Well, don't you think that's a rather insensitive way to deal with one of life's disadvantaged, Smith?
Well, not really, sir, no. I mean, that's what he comes in for. And like I said, he goes away happy. What more can I do?
Well, you can stop referring to such people as nutters for a start, Constable. Try putting yourself in Mr. Grimwade's place for once. Yes?
Yes, sir.
And ask Sergeant Peters to call me up as soon as the Chief Super gets in, will you?
Right, sir.
Will do.
Was that Inspector Kite?
Certainly was.
Has he gone out?
Well, he had his cap and radio, Sarge.
What's he going out for? He never goes out on Mondays. He's got no right. What did he say?
No. But he wants you to ring him as soon as Brownlow gets it.
Why?
How should I know? He's probably checking up to see if he's not late.
Better not be.
Come on! Hold it, come on!
So you're managing to put up with this all right then?
Sorry, Skipper?
Life at Sunhill.
I like it very much, yes.
Not getting too hard a time of it, the likes of Shaw and Edwards?
Well, they wind me up now and then. But they're good guys, really.
Occasional wind-up's all part of the game. Mind it doesn't get too silly. I mean, what are mates for if not to take the piss out of me?
That's why I don't mind. I like being part of the team. That's the best thing. At home, my family's... We're a team, we're all Hindus. The old girl's everything. 294, receiving.
Dinesh, a call receiving. 222 Topsbridge Road. Mr. Hanley, a big goal, but it sounds like a breaking entrance. Can you open the deal, please? That's 222 Topsbridge Road. No suspects for me.
Yes, dear Oscar, will you? Topsbridge Road, Skipper.
Well, go on, it's your shout. You know where it is, don't you?
Yes, sir.
Well, then. Quite nice around here.
Mr. Hanley.
That bleeding sign.
What seems to be the problem, sir?
It's my mum. She's been raped by a bleeding spade.
I've got the old bill. About mum, you old twat.
What?
Well, don't just bleed and stand there.
You say she's been...
raped. That's what I said. We was all asleep, like. Then there's a crash. And this bloody great black guy comes busting in through the door. High on drugs, I suppose, like they all are. Me and him's well pissed, like. Can't do nothing about it. He's got a knife anyway. Takes our money. But then he grabs Mum, pulls her down there on the floor, and...
When did this happen, sir?
How do I know? I passed out before I could get down to the phone. We'd had a bit of an all-night session, like I say. The old twat's birthday.
Let's make your mum a bit more comfortable, sir.
The bedroom's upstairs.
Yeah, right.
Come
on. Okay. Up. Okay. Up. That's it. One more. Knock me down. All right.
Sorry, sorry.
All right. Come on. Up.
Got it.
That's it. Come here.
Jeans and a dark t-shirt, blue, I think.
It really would be a great help if you could be more precise about the time.
Well, I can't. Look, you just get out of there and pull a few in. There's enough of them.
Well, yes. But your description...
Look, I'd know him if I saw him, all right? You just pull in a dozen and line them up. I'll pick the bastard out, no sweat.
We'll proceed with our inquiries then, sir.
Still asleep, is she?
Yeah. Yeah, she'll be all right. Police doctor will have to examine her, of course, sir.
How do you mean? She ain't hurt. Look, I don't want no one else mucking her about.
I'm afraid it always has to be done in rape cases, sir. I'll get someone round as soon as possible.
Okay, way outside, yeah?
Had a key then, did he, Mr. Hamley?
What?
The intruder. That front door hasn't been forced.
No, well, we probably never locked it. We was all well...
Well pissed?
Yeah, right.
Yeah. Excuse me.
This place doesn't look as if it's been broken into.
You know how they identify rapists, don't you, sir? You know how they prove beyond doubt who's done it? With human hair. They take a single hair from the head of the suspect and they analyze it. Then they take a sample of the fluids found on the victim's body and they analyze that. And if the elements match, that's your man. And of course, the first thing they have to do, it's a process of elimination, you see, is take a hair from the head of the victim's male relatives. That's your dad and you. You do understand what I'm saying, don't you, sir? Right. Well, the doctor will be here in less than an hour, and I get a WPC to come and talk to your mum, and she can do the necessary concerning the hair. And in the meantime, I'll,
forget it.
Sorry?
Forget it, yeah?
Well, the intruder?
Yeah, I'm not sure about... I'm not sure it was... Forget it, please.
Somebody has tried to have sex with your mother, Mr. Hamley. I'll call back tomorrow when you all serve it up.
Sorry, skipper.
9292 Sierra Oscar receiving, over.
Yes, Sarge?
Topbridge Road, no further action, June. Looks like an all-night drinking session. Got themselves a little confused. Over.
Right, thanks, Sarge.
Some stones are best left unturned, yeah? Fancy a cover? Well, no, I do.
Anyway, you're doing all right, Dinesh. But don't be in too much hurry to take this thing off, eh? I know you want to be polite when you go indoors, but suss the place out first. Could be a maniac behind the door with a hammer in his hand. I know it's not a crash helmet, but it helps.
Yeah, okay.
Right, I'll get off your back now. I'll see you later, huh?
Yeah, see you later. Thanks for your help, Skipper.
No, that's all right. See you later, Don.
Police officer!
You bollocks! Where's your warrant card?
Get Nick!
Lock that! Lock it or show me your warrant card if you want to let Breedy go! All right, son! You nicked!
All right, Jim, do you need assistance?
So what's what you're doing here?
Tree planted thing. I never allowed
them. Oh, Bob. Hello. What are you doing in here? I'm not allowed to go for a piss when I'm in the cab room. You look a bit hot and bothered. Getting too old for the job, right?
I just had to give one of your brothers a dig out.
Who's that?
Jimmy Carver.
He's not in yet, is he?
Super cops do it standing at bus stops.
Chief Superintendent, Sarge.
Right. Bloody 10 minutes late.
If I'd let go, he could have stuck a knife in me for all I knew.
I told him as soon as I could, Sarge.
Not when I was getting on the bus, you never. You just started a bleeding rush!
I'm afraid it doesn't really matter whether you knew he's a police officer or not, sir. You see, under common law, every citizen has a right and duty to restrain another from causing a breach of the peace.
Do what?
You don't have to be a police officer to stop someone causing a riot by jumping a bus queue. This officer could have been Cinderella on her way to the ball. He'd have still been within his rights in doing what he did. Correct, PC Carver?
Yeah, it's all right, Sarge.
Excuse me, Tom, it's going to take very long.
That depends on Mr. Sturgis.
I see, right. Well, when you do eventually arrive for work, Carver, I've got a job for you upstairs.
Get off, mate! Leave me alone! Get off! Sit down there!
Oh,
morning,
sir. The chief super's clerk asked me to give you these.
Oh, what are they?
The cases thrown out by the CPS.
What, all of them?
Yeah. If you ask me, this Crown Prosecution Service is one big cocker.
I didn't ask you, Ollis.
Here, go and see Taffy Edwards, then. Only the clerk's got his exam results.
Is the chief super in now?
Excuse me, sir. Only the, well, I was first in the queue, and it's Federation business.
Yes? Yes, Hollis?
Oh.
Jean, that's for D.I. Galloway.
I do have an appointment, sir, made last Friday, to discuss the latest recommendations on civilianisation.
Nothing to discuss, is there? The field trial on Front Desk Post has been a success. That's full steam ahead. I see no reason why Sun Hill shouldn't have a civilian on the front desk within 3 months.
Yeah, well, I don't like the idea at all, sir.
Oh, really? I understood the Federation were giving its full cooperation.
Yeah, well, I'm entitled to give a local view, and I think it's all wrong, especially regarding the front desk. I mean, people coming into a police station expect to see a policeman. That is why they've come. We've already lost our socos. Now it's the front desk. They're even experimenting with civvies in custody areas. But what's going to be next?
The collator?
Oh, no, look, they've only thrown out Emerson. That's a month's work down the drain.
Well, there's a Crown Prosecution Service for you. You pay peanuts, you get monkeys.
You don't seem very worried about it.
To be honest, I've given up worrying. I'll do my bit. If they can't do theirs, tough titties. It's the same old story. A good idea, no money to make it work. Like the police.
So Ollis coming out.
Good morning, Ollis. Sir?
Morning, sir.
Balls.
see, in the good old days, you could take care of an evil bastard like Emerson by planting a shotgun in the boot of his car.
I'm not interested in the good old days, Ted. All I want is the CPS to accept good, real evidence and for you to stop pretending you don't give a toss when I know you do. Now, what are you doing today?
Time expired, con man.
All right, Gov.
Finished downstairs, have you?
I'm sorry about that.
Hold up last night at Bloy Road filling station. It's all yours. Details on your desk.
Right, Gov.
And don't go by bus.
Well, don't feel you need to tell me, Brian. Just send it straight to heaven like you usually do.
I was thinking over the weekend about our lunchtime junketings on the Porterfield estate. Well, how about if we used a couple of bicycles?
Bicycles?
Mm, our two new roadsters have been delivered this morning. I'm not suggesting you should actually ride one, sir.
You're not?
No. A couple of PCs. Well, they can meet us there, let the local kiddies sit on the saddle for photos, etc., while you plant the tree.
No, I'm not planting the damn tree. That's Harry Bracewell's job.
Unfortunately, sir, the CLO can't be with us. He rang on Friday after you'd gone home.
Backsliding bastard.
Oh, and as you'll now be the senior force representative present, I thought these might be helpful, sir. Just a few notes for your speech. I'll see you at midday, sir.
Thank you, Brian.
Morning, Roy.
Go away!
Oh, come on, Sarge. You won't be the only old crumbly there. Kevin Sack's coming.
Yeah, I don't want to crack your style. Thanks for all the same, Viv.
Yeah, all the relief will be then.
Oh, then that's it. I certainly ain't going. What, Saturday night with Yorkie Henshaw? Stop, man.
Bob, sir, are you busy?
I'm just about to get a bit of breakfast, sir.
Can I wait for 5 minutes?
Well, I expect so.
Shut the door. We need to have a chat, Bob.
Do we, sir?
I'm afraid so. What about? These for a start. Warrants awaiting execution.
Yes, well, I can see what they are, sir.
They've been lying in the Corris bin since last Thursday. One in Shaw's, one in Martella's. Two questions present themselves. First, why haven't the officers concerned dealt with them? Second, why haven't you ensured that they have?
Well, it's only Monday, sir.
And that makes it all right, does it? Only Monday.
Well, Shaw certainly never forgets a warrant. He loves them.
But you haven't seen fit to chase them up. You do check the Corris bins regularly.
No, as it happens, sir, I don't anymore.
Oh? Might I ask why?
Well, I know that you'll be checking them anyway, sir. Seems a duplication of effort, us both doing them.
You're saying I interfere?
Well, it is your prerogative, sir, but you are the first inspector I've had who's found interfering necessary.
And you quite obviously resent that.
Well, let's put it this way, sir. I have been a copper now for 18 years, and 12 of them I've been a sergeant. I'm getting a bit old to be taught how to suck eggs.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that, Sergeant, because I'm getting a little impatient with the lackadaisical manner in which your relief conduct themselves.
Your relief, Inspector, not my relief. You're supposed to be the team leader.
Yes, and despite my repeated warnings...
Oh, yes, warnings. We get plenty of them. I'll say that for you, sir.
Their locker room is an absolute tip. Their dress is sloppy. They're unpunctual and frequently absent from their beats.
Warnings and bloody lectures, policing by objectives. Hey, the image of the pushbike, at a stand at the bleeding urinal.
Don't you dare walk outside.
I'm not walking out, I am standing up, and there is no directive on that, is there, Inspector?
You may think you're a law unto yourself in this place, Sergeant Cryer, but you're not. The standard that I expect, the standard the modern service demands, applies to you just as much as to others.
Clean shirt, regulation tie, polished boots. And you can check my locker too if you want to, sir. No crisp packets, no dirty books.
And when you're out... I know all your lads' watering holes, Sergeant. I've made it my business to find out. And yours as well. And may I say that, in my opinion, scrounging about at tea stalls is hardly the sort of example to set an impressionable young officer like Patel.
You've been spying on me?
You have.
You've been spying on me.
It's called supervision, Sergeant. An aspect of the job you sadly seem to neglect.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, Melvin?
That's a choice, sir.
Just put it in the tray, please.
It's marked urgent, sir.
Thank you, Melvin.
Yes, sir.
Had you finished, sir?
Yes, Sergeant. For the moment.
Having fun out there today, Sarge?
Hello, right, Brian. Look, I wonder if you could do me a bit of a favour. You know this tree planting ceremony on the Porterfield estate this morning? Well, something rather important's just cropped up. I don't suppose you'd be willing to
hold the Chief Super's hand? Yeah, why not? Shouldn't take too long, should it? Right, you're on. It's no problem, Brian. I always think the CID should become more involved in the community aspect, don't you? Right. Cheers, then.
That's so funny.
Operation Mushroom, actually.
Miss Paul?
Yeah?
Jimmy Carver, CID at Sun Hill.
Yeah?
About the hold-up last night, you're on duty when it happened.
I'm always on duty.
Well, what I got here is the man was white, young, medium height, had a mask over his face and was carrying a handgun, probably a replica. You gave him what was in the till, that was £51.
Yep.
Did he speak at all?
Nah.
Now, is there anything you can give us by way of description? You know, what he was wearing, distinguishing marks?
He was well hung.
Sorry?
He was well hung. You know, he had a big one. Quite impressive.
You mean he had no clothes on?
Nothing at all. Well, except for the mask. Straight up. Well, straight down, fortunately.
Why didn't you mention this last night then, Miss Paul, when the area car responded?
What, them couple of machos? Swaggering in here with the caps down over their eyes? Well, I wasn't going to give them a thrill. You seem harmless enough, though.
Come in.
This has just arrived for you, sir.
Thank you, Smith.
Excuse me, sir. The bicycles have just arrived.
Ah, right. Thanks, Tom.
We used to get sevenpence a mile, you know, when I was your age.
To what, Sarge?
Bicycle allowance.
Oh.
Excuse me, Gov. That hold-up guy was stark bollock naked.
Yeah, I know. He's just done another one.
What, in broad daylight?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I reckon it's the same little bugger who's been posing as a milkman.
Yeah, well, we think there's Terry Atchison. Only trouble is, he's supposed to be in Scotland at the moment. What is the MO?
Well, he goes into some tatty-looking corner shop, says he's a health inspector, and has a lookout for some time-expired sausages, and then offers the owner the choice of being reported or giving a hefty contribution to the NSPCC.
Yeah, which he collects. Yeah, well, that sounds like Terry's style, right?
Reg?
Yeah?
Oh, sorry, Ted. How are you on the Ghoulies?
Oh, sorry, mate.
Look, I'm after a guy whose idea of a disguise is to wear sod all.
Now, what, is he a rapist?
No, armed robber, filling stations. Well, it's a replica, actually.
A replica?
The gun.
Oh, I see. What is he, black, white?
He's white.
White, yeah, well, I haven't got anything on fire, well, I don't think. Beau have just notified of a dipper with a wooden leg, and I've had a couple of reports of a flasher over on the common. Is, well, he's black.
So it's Terence Hutchinson, then?
He'd be my choice, Ted, yeah.
Right, but we start off with him.
If you can find him. What sort of age is he?
Well, his early 20s, medium height.
Yeah? Any other distinguishing features other than his doodah?
Well, nobody seems to have noticed. Uh-huh. But he has done two in 6 hours, one last night and one an hour ago. Both times the cashiers were girls.
Yeah, and he just walks in with his gun, does he?
Well, it just appears, yeah. Mm. Look, the second time, it was definitely a replica.
Yeah? Small amounts?
Well, just what's in the till, you know, 50 quid or so.
Mm. Well, most of our recidivists are out of circulation at the moment, as you probably know. But Robin Kitchen, now he's about the right age and height. The only trouble is he's a grab and flea boy mostly, and he always wears a tracksuit too.
Well, it's easy enough to take off.
Yeah, that's true. Do you know he did an off licence once with a toy gun? Well, we say he did. His brief told a good one. Which filling stations?
That's Bloy Road and one at the end of Fellingdale.
Yeah? Well, that is Robbie's petrol, right? Why don't you give him a pull? Give him a pull.
Nine two from Sierra Oscar, over.
9-2 receiving, over.
You all right out there, Robert? What are you up to?
Counting to 10 and thinking of my pension.
That's saddle high enough.
Yes, thank you very much, sir.
Good. Now, we've had our difficulties with the Porterfield estate in the past. Today, we're taking a step towards greater mutual trust and understanding. Towards more sensitive policing.
Oh, so if we see somebody out of order, we don't nick them, sir?
Use your discretion, sure, as always. Get yourselves a cup of tea.
Thank you very much, sir.
Hello, Sergeant Bryant.
Joan?
Thought you'd retired.
No, not yet.
Me neither.
9-2 from Sierra Oscar, receiving, over.
Yeah, 9-2 receiving, over.
Sarge, are you on 4-beat now?
I am indeed.
A call from Caprillo Gardens. A Mrs. Hardesty at number 29. She's worried about her neighbours, elderly couple, not answering the door.
OK, June. Will do.
Thanks, 9-2.
He's on his way.
You can tell me, you know. I won't grass.
Seen or heard anything for 2 days. They've got a daughter down in Chatham, but I don't think they could have gone down there. They would have let me know. And Dolly's been a bit frail lately anyhow. This is me, 29. This is them. Put the milk in case it got pinched.
Mr. Pollard? Mrs. Pollard? Mr. Pollard! Mrs. Pollard!
There's a light on in there somewhere. Perhaps she's got a spare key, have you?
Only when they go away, they always leave it with me then.
Is there a caretaker?
You're joking.
Well, let's break in then. Mr. Pollard.
Sorry to disturb you, sir.
Is your wife all right, Mr. Pollard?
Get out, you stupid woman. This is our bedroom.
Shall we make your wife a bit more comfortable, sir?
No. She's fine where she is.
Divisional surgeon and a mortuary van, yeah? And tell them to come to number 29 first, right? I don't want them just tramping in.
I've got that, Sarge.
Right, Mrs. Hardister, you might as well go and sit down. No more you can do. And thanks for your help.
Mr. Pollard? Cup of tea, Mr. Pollard. Yeah?
You're Sergeant Cryer, aren't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, I saw you. I understand the station. Dolly lost her purse.
To get it back? How long were you married, Mr. Pollard?
We still are married.
Sorry. How long have you been married?
60 years.
Must have seen some good times together, eh?
I'm not letting her go without me. We always said we'd wait for each other.
You know what? I think that dentist has filled the wrong bloody tooth.
Sierra Oscar 5, Sierra Oscar 5 from Sierra Oscar.
5 receiving, over.
Sierra Oscar 5, call just received from the Geels Corner Service Station.
Not another one?
Naked suspect still on the scene, Oscar 5. The area car has been called, but if you're adjacent.
Yeah, we're on our way to Kinchin's house.
Police officer. Well, there's his pop.
Gone, is he?
As he ill. He's in here.
Well, I don't know what you expect me to do about it, Roy.
Basically, sir, kick up a stink. If all the chief supers in the Met would have put pen to paper about the Crown Prosecution Service...
Nothing would happen. Morning, Ted.
Any luck with Hutchinson?
No, not a trace.
No, never mind. You've got two burglaries and a GBH upstairs.
Thanks. Shouldn't you two be on your way?
Come on, man. There's nobody about here.
Extension 2962, please. Ah, Superintendent Chivers. It's Brian Kite here, Sir Sun Hill. I've got the samples. Shall I arrange delivery or will you send somebody? The mud, sir. Canister of highly toxic waste lost in the Thames. I was personally tasked because of the secrecy. I had a message through the CAD room and the letter. I see. Well, sorry to have troubled you, sir. Goodbye.
Councillor Bradley, ladies and gentlemen, it's taken a lot of hard work to achieve what we're achieving here today. The initiatives to decrease crime and enhance the quality of life on the Porterfield estate have been a joint effort. And I'm only sorry that Harry Bracewell, the police community liaison officer, who's done so much to forge this new understanding partnership, cannot be with us today. But in his absence, I would now like to plant this symbolic partnership tree.
Here you are, sir.
Thank you. Its roots, deep in the earth we all tread. Its branches, spread to the sun that gives us all life. A symbol of shared experience.
These are from SO3, sir.
SO3?
The yard, sir.
Very well, sir. Best you do it with the bikes. And your speech, of course.
Easy.
No!
Now, easy, mate.
No!
Easy, easy. Easy, come on, come on. Come on, come on. She's all right.
He's got a really terrific one. He's like this, right? hang on a minute. Control Sun Hill. Yeah, sorry? Oh, yes, hold on a sec, will you, please? June, it's for you, lad.
Yeah, go on.
It's
Ciara for me.
Hello? I'm sorry for it. He's got his clothes on like this. It's magic!
When you say deteriorate...
I don't know what copy she's got. I mean, net-wide distribution of the release. They just can't tell me. That's why... Oh, yeah, I feel really drained. I think this is the most risky one I've ever done. Well...
Are you trying to tell me he's dead? Yes. Yes, I'll come along straight away. Thank you.
Look, a wind-up by the lads is one thing, Alec, but once a sergeant starts to undermine the authority of a senior officer...
Yeah, well, we thought you might be a bit po-faced about it. That's why we never bothered to tell you.
Oh, po-faced, yeah. Crusty old Uncle Bob. Well, as it happens, Alec, I agree with you. The man's a prat. But unlike you and me, he is young enough and clever enough to change. What about June?
June?
Well, I gave it to you to look after for the day, didn't I?
Oh, she had a phone call from the hospital just before 2, yeah.
And?
Don't know exactly. I was talking to Tom.
Cheers, Alec. But she was glad of your care and attention, wasn't she?
Constabulary duties to be done, come in.
Yes, Sergeant. Keeping your head down till the relief's all gone, sir?
To gloat, have you?
Actually, I wasn't in on it, so. Nevertheless, enjoy it. No doubt everyone else will. Well, I dare say there are some people who think you had it coming, sir. Doesn't mean I find it funny.
I appreciate your frankness, Sergeant, and your magnanimity. I overstepped the mark in our little chat this morning. I apologize. But as for the rest, I'm afraid they'll find that being unpopular, being the butt of practical jokes, which take up vast amounts of police time and resources, will in no way deflect me from doing my job.
Well, I wish you luck then, sir. And with your singing.
Don't tell me you're a Gilbert and Sullivan fan.
No, sir, I prefer Verdi. Something with a bit more balls.